2012, Chris and Colleen Urquhart bought a classic mid-century ranch home in an upscale Southern California neighborhood. And in their backyard, they discovered a perfectly preserved nuclear fallout shelter from 1961.
It's incredible. We didn't really know that we had a bunker. And once we were able to come into the house during our escrow, that was the time when we discovered that we had one.
This bunker was built at the height of nuclear Cold War fears. It contained everything a family of four would need to survive for weeks during a full-on nuclear attack on America. And 50 years later, it's still there.
And hope, welcome back to shelter. Let me show you some things we have down here. Fairly warm coffee down here. It says right now from the 60s. Again, I love the packaging. Yeah, this is curious. I'm almost sure that that's a can of octopus. So don't eat that.
This shelter was built for a very specific threat. The year 1961. The Soviet Union gives America an ultimatum. Get out of West Berlin. President John F. Kennedy replies frankly. Any attack on West Berlin leads inevitably to nuclear war. Since the first atomic bombs at Hiroshima and Nagasaki, the world had feared nuclear war. Now, in 1961, nuclear war seemed imminent.
Never have the nations of the world had so much to lose.
Governments around the globe began building underground shelters, fortified to protect the occupants from the initial blast. They were also stocked with food and supplies, as survivors would have to remain underground and wait until the radioactive fallout diminished to safe levels. For those with the know-how and resources, building their own shelter was the best solution. Deborah Kaufman was 10 when her father began building this shelter.
My father worked on military projects the majority of his career. He was completely inundated in his work life with what nuclear effects, what radiation did to objects, instrumentation, and of course people. As an engineer, he saw it as a problem to be solved, and the solution was building a fallout shelter.
The shelter took weeks to complete, with a subcontractor pouring the concrete-lined room 15 feet underground.
Once the fallout shelter was finished, my dad almost immediately moved in the kinds of supplies he thought we would need.
I have four places to sleep. You have these two areas down here. And then you have your sleep beds where I guess the kids would sleep. Over here, we have some more food stuffs. This is kind of interesting, actually. It's a survival life pack food. So it's some canned food.
The backyard bunker was not the work of a lone nut. It was carefully based on official U.S. government standards for nuclear war planning.
This wasn't some kooky idea that he had on his own. There was a lot of government stuff going on to make certain that people would be safe in case of a nuclear attack. And the government was asking people to build fallout shelters. There were plenty of government publications showing you exactly how to do it.
So let's talk a little about these things, about what you can do to protect yourself.
Public service announcements and even government-sponsored TV ads promoted nuclear war preparation.